So yes, as you saw from the thumbnail and title of this video, I'm gonna make a wedding dress, and no, I am not getting married. But I always want to make a wedding dress, and I get comments all the time telling me you should be a wedding dress designer, you should make a wedding dress. So here we are, we're gonna make a wedding dress, and I'm very, very excited. Every time I pass this fabric in Joann's, I want to get it so bad, but it's $40 a yard, so I'm a cheapskate, and I never, ever, ever get it. But I did splurge, and I bought all of the fabric that my Joann's had, and we're gonna start it this week, and I'm so, so excited. I'm hoping to get it done in about 3 or 4 days, and I have a sketch ready, I have all my fabric ready, and it's time to dive into this. So let me show you the materials that I have. So this is the fabric that I always want. I'm just kidding, it's really not. This is the base fabric. It's an ivory matte satin. And I got ivory because I didn't want this to be like a bright in your face moment. And I wanted to let the beautiful expensive fabric shine, which is this beautiful floral loud fabric. Do you guys hear this? But if you look at it, it has flowers all over it and these beautiful vines. And every time I see it, I want to get it so bad. Do you guys see that? Do you see it? Look at the flowers, because it also has this beautiful scallop. And you guys, this fabric may have been a fortune, but we're going to make the most beautiful wedding dress anyone has ever seen. And I just want to say one more time, I am not getting married. I don't even have a boyfriend. So, now for the sketch. So recently I bought an iPad because I can't really sketch. I'm sorry, but this was just so funny and I had to show it to you. At all, I used Procreate, and this is my sketch. It's actually not really the wedding dress design I would probably choose if I were to get married, but I felt like this fabric needed something more, and I think it's beautiful. Before we get started, make sure to like this video and subscribe if you haven't already, because I'm gonna be having some amazing fun videos for you guys really soon, and I'm really excited about where this is going to be going to. So please subscribe, like the video, and let's get to draping the pattern. Hi guys. This is my mannequin. She doesn't have a name. Give me name suggestions in the comments below. If you don't have a mannequin, I have a beginner-friendly one that's very affordable linked in my description box below. And it's adjustable, and it's what I had before I got this one. So go check it out if you're looking to get one of your own. But this is my beautiful, nice mannequin that I have. It's gonna be very simple. I'll show you guys how I do it, and we're just gonna get started. With some muslin fabric, I'm gonna be pinning it on so it's form-fitting to my dress form, and then I'm going to end up sketching where I want the pattern to be. This process is fairly simple. I don't find it difficult at all. It just takes a bit of learning and practice, but it's kind of boring to watch, so we're just gonna time lapse it and you guys can see what I do.
Excuse me, I need a bit of this fabric, please. Can I have a little fabric?
We have the base pattern done. It's gonna have very, very deep V. Probably put mesh up in here so that it, you know, holds it together. And then I want a really low scooped back, because then I'm gonna have the lace that's see-through coming down like that. I think it's gonna be really pretty. Hopefully this fits. I'll probably do a mock-up this time. I really want it to look good since it was so expensive. This is the base, and now I'll probably just drape a quick little thing for the V, but I'm kinda gonna wing that part too. I don't know. Okay everybody, we have our pattern. I promise there's a vision up in here. So there's a pattern piece that's gonna go like this, and then this is gonna be made out of the lace so that we have like this sheer open back with the scalloped edges going down. It's a bit hard to visualize maybe. Kind of see how it's gonna be, but I have no idea how I'm gonna actually construct it. And we're gonna take this off. I'll probably do a mock-up because I want this to actually fit, but I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. It was kind of the idea I had in my head. So let's hope it fits. Let's do it. We have our mock-up, and I only did one half because I was feeling lazy and I didn't want to cut fabric out. It looks kind of small. Okay, a bit confusing. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna need like mesh holding this up, or else there's gonna be an accident. see I have the inner flap that's gonna kind of go down a bit small. It's gonna go in like that, and then the lace will go down.
After trying the pattern on, I decided I'm not gonna redo the mock-up to fix the problem. I'm just gonna dive in, hope for the best, you know, what I usually do. Patterning and cutting the pattern out is the worst part of sewing. I just hate it so much. I do not like cutting fabric. I just don't like it. It's not fun and it hurts my hand. So we're gonna cut the fabric out, and then from there I'll figure out how to actually make it.
Well, that took forever to cut out, like half an hour maybe, because all of the little flowers are connected by these metal things on the back. So every time I'm cutting over it and it's in my way, I have to take these little things and cut the metal off and then keep going. And not only that, but it was just really stressful because of how expensive it was. And I kind of had to pattern match on the lace because I wanted the flowers to be in the right spot. So now we're gonna start sewing the bodice together. And I think what's gonna work the best is if I sew the lace separately as one bodice and the satin separately as a different bodice and completely finish them. And then when they're both done, I'll put the lace on top of the satin and hand sew it on. So we're gonna hope for the best. Probably that's what my method is gonna be. I'll let you know if I change that. So for now, I'm going to sew the satin together. And then after that, I'll sew the lace because the lace is gonna be a nightmare to sew. So I'm gonna put it off as far as possible. Let's hope it fits because I am out of fabric because the rest needs to go to the skirt. Ew, what is that? All sticky. I will pray for the best. I think I'm gonna put a smidge of support in the side seam and just stick a zip tie in there. I'm not gonna put it anywhere else, but I wanted to have that structure just so that it stays all straight, and I just need really a side piece of boning to do that. Now on these edges where it's curved is the place where I'm sewing the lining to the outer fabric. I'm actually going to start clipping these edges on the curves. This way it really keeps there from being a lot of bulk when you turn the seam right side out. It's a good thing to do because you don't want a lot of bulk where the seam is. So this way I can top stitch it down and it won't be bulky. And then on the corners, I will clip the corners off like that because you just don't want all of that extra fabric inside the seam, if that makes sense. So I've flipped it right side out and I'm gonna top stitch down the seam because I don't wanna iron it. So it's faster for me just to top stitch. And so I'm gonna do that and have to repeat with the other side. And yes, I am watching Dance Moms. I'm always watching a show when I sew, and it's usually gonna be something like Dance Moms. So I'm gonna top stitch this and then do the same thing with this piece, and then we'll be ready to move on to this monstrosity. I have everything pinned on, and oh my gosh, it looks so cute. I did have to redo this piece, so this is not how it's gonna be. It's gonna be connected in the middle and be on here too. So we'll have the lace covering this so it's a bit more modest, because let's be honest, that's too low. And so it will be kind of holding this together. And then the back, I don't have this piece, but it's gonna go really low, and then this lace is gonna be going in a V with the scalloped edges. So the next step now that I have this sewn is to sew these pieces together, and then we'll start on hand sewing everything together. So now I'm hand sewing this in place, kind of at the shoulder seams and at the armholes, and then I'll sew it down here so that this is attached to the white part. After a couple hours of hand sewing yesterday, I finally finished sewing this all to the bodice, and I think it's looking so beautiful. I tried it on and I'm really, really excited about it. But my favorite part is the back. You guys haven't seen this yet. I love, love, love this V it goes into with the scalloped edge and how it's totally sheer except for that very bottom part. So now that this is done, we can start working on the skirt, which will hopefully be much easier and faster. And I have a feeling I might actually get to finish this today. Okay guys, it's finally time to make the skirt, and I don't really know what we're gonna do. I think for this, I'll probably do a half circle skirt just because I don't want a lot of bulk in the waist. So that will be fairly simple, half circle skirt with this matte satin. The problem is that I cannot do that with this because of the way that it's patterned. And I really love the scalloped edge and I want that for the hem. Now, I'll probably end up doing triangular patterns, but because of the way the triangle is, if I do that, then the size of the triangle will make it not an even hem, if that makes sense. And normally you could just hem it so that it's all even, but that's kind of hard to do when the hem is a certain hem that you want to keep, the scalloped edge. So we'll probably just do it and see if it works out. But if you look at the mannequin, if you have this draped over, it is so pretty. And then I realized that I do not have a zipper. So I'm gonna have to get to the store to get a zipper if I wanna finish this today. And the other thing you need to take into account when doing the hem is what shoes you're gonna be wearing. And I think I'm going to do these nude Louboutins. And they are like 4-inch heels. So I'm gonna have to add 4 inches to the hem, which I don't know how long that will be. So we're gonna put these on and measure how far down it will go. And then I'll start cutting out the satin and we'll just go from there and see how things go. I do love these shoes though. And I love wearing them. And I think they're so simple yet beautiful. And I think they'll go beautiful with this dress. Let's cut. I've donned the shoes. They add such height and I'm digging how they look with these overalls. It's kind of a fit. Anyway, we're gonna measure it. I think I want it to be just sweeping the ground. So it's coming up at about 45 inches, I would say, because you don't want it to be like going up above, but I think it's gonna look so cute with this dress. Simpler, I've folded it over so that that's less to cut because that's a waste of time. Behind me, I have it pinned in place. This is just pinned and it looks so good, you guys. Look at this. This is so beautiful. It's exactly what was in my head. Oh my gosh, now we gotta sew it together and it's gonna be a little more gathered and I can't wait. The only thing that is a bit not good is that, if you can tell, I think I cut the satin layer a little too long, so I'm going to have to hem it quite a bit because I want this to be a little longer. So luckily I did give myself some room with cutting it 45 inches because I want it to be as long as possible. Isn't that beautiful? Probably just spent a good 20 or 30 minutes taking all of the pearls out of the seam lines for this skirt. Look at all of the pearls and little metal things that I've taken out. That took forever and my hand feels all cramped now, but now we can actually sew the skirt now that we got that out of the way. So we're gonna assemble and see how it looks. As always, my sewing machine is right there, and everything I use to sew will be linked in the description box below if you want to purchase your own. I have the panels of this skirt gathered and sewn together. And I think it's really, really cute. Definitely the vibe for this fabric. And the next step is to do this skirt, but I think that I'm actually, this right now is a half circle, and I'm going to take a bit off so that it's a quarter circle because the circumference of this hem being a half circle is way longer inch-wise than the circumference of this hem. And I don't want this to be all bunched underneath. And then I'm gonna hem it shorter too because it's a bit longer than this. But other than that, it's good. We're in the final step, and all that's left is to sew the bodice to the skirt and add a zipper. And I did, I know I mentioned earlier that I had to go to the store to get a zipper. I did find this one, but I'm kind of bummed because it's not an invisible zipper. It's a normal one, and I really don't like these. I don't like how they look, but I'm gonna try to just make it invisible because I don't want to go to the store. I just want to finish the dress. So that's good. We have a zipper. So we're just gonna sew this on. I already have it pinned and it's gonna be really easy.
Literally gonna cry. I thought that I took all the pearls out and I literally just broke my needle. I take back what I said about having to go to the store because I think I'm out. Let me check. That is always the last thing you want to see when sewing. Darn it.
Well, I'm plumb out of needles. I'll check a few more places. I don't think I have any extras. I guess we're gonna go to the store. That's fine because I suppose I can get an invisible zipper while I'm at it. But that's really annoying because I was literally sewing the very last detail and I totally forgot a pearl. After all the trouble I went through to take all of the pearls out and I missed a pearl. Oh, okay, let's go to the store. It's fine. I have time. What are you gonna do?
My car is almost out of gas, but that's a different day's problem. I ran into Hobby Lobby really quick. I got 10 needles, so hopefully I don't have to come back for needles in a while. Got my ivory zipper that's invisible. And also, I decided that to clean up inside where the bodice and skirt are being sewn together, I would get some bias tape. And they had this soft hem tape that I'm interested about. Feels bridal-ish. And if that doesn't work, I just got regular bias tape that's cotton. And there's somebody coming. Okay, see you at home.
You walking down the aisle.
Shut up. Mine's fine. This is so funny.
What?
Just keep it rolling. Catch.
That didn't make any sense. Get it, girl. Get it, girl.
Oh, go ahead.
You can
We're
go for
some video.
Did you put a ring on? No.